before the pandemic. So then the court closed on March 19th, increasing the backlog significantly. About 1,500 foster children are normally adopted in LA County every single year, and that's all backed up now. These are kids trying to get into a forever home with a loving family. As expected, the NBA's Board of Governors approved a proposal for 22 teams to return to play July 31st at Walt Disney World Resort in Orlando. A few things still need to be figured out, but it looks very likely that the Lakers and Clippers will be able to compete for a championship this year. How fantastic is that? Sports is something that we have desperately missed. I want everyone to be safe as we go through this stuff, but we have desperately missed that this year. All right, 6:50, it's Valentine in the morning.
Traffic is sponsored by DuckDuckGo Privacy. There's a signal on the 110 freeway northbound connector to the westbound side of the 105. That transition road is shut down because of a cement mixer that's on its side. Traffic's a little bit busy. They're coming away from El Segundo, and then further north on the 110, traffic is slowing down from Exposition towards the 10 freeway. In downtown on the 10 freeway, eastbound side just before you get to Santa Fe, they're saying there's a two-car fender bender there that's blocking the right lane, so watch for traffic slowing down to come up on that. Westbound side of the 10 is pretty heavy from the 5 over towards the 110, but they're not too bad of a head for your drive through mid-city. And then on the 10th freeway in the Loma Linda area, the freeway is shut down completely because of a warehouse that's on fire. Eastbound side is shut down at Mountain View with the backup of the 215. Westbound side is shut down at California Street. You're backed up there from the 210. Take the 210 or the 215 as your alternates and just to kind of avoid that area altogether. Want the same internet but more privacy? DuckDuckGo's got you covered. They have millions of people like you get privacy online without any trade-offs. With one download, you can search and browse privately, avoiding trackers all for free. DuckDuckGo, privacy simplified. That's your traffic. I'm Tony Jordan with Valentine in the Morning on 104.3 MyFM.
Valentine in the Morning.
Hollywood headlines.
Ed Sheeran announced in December that he was going to be taking another break from social media, self-imposed hiatus. After being on tour for 2 years, he wanted a break. Now there's this South African singer named Jeremy Loops who is saying that before Ed stepped away, the two of them worked on some new music together. He said, I arrived in the studio early in the morning and we worked all day on a few different songs. So Ed might actually have some new music recorded and ready to go whenever he decides to reemerge. And it just hit me this morning when I was kind of like looking this up and looking up Ed, that we really haven't heard from him since December. No, nothing. No tweets, no Instagram posts, all through the coronavirus pandemic, nothing. And his plan when he announced his hiatus was to travel. That most likely hasn't happened. So I'm just so curious about what Ed Sheeran has been doing.
Huh. Frank's hanging out on that farm in his, I think, right? Probably drinking a lot of beer at that pub down the street.
Yeah. And Jill said the other day that he's, like, brewing at home now. So I guess that is what he's doing.
He's, like, drinking too much alcohol during quarantine.
Yeah, right. And our longtime friend, Selena Gomez, is one of the most followed people on Instagram, 178 million followers. And she said that she's been struggling to know the right things to say regarding George Floyd and Black Lives Matter. When you have that many followers, I'm sure you choose your words very carefully. It's a big responsibility. She just announced that she's going to turn her account over to some black leaders and let them use her massive platform. She said, after thinking about it, I decided that we all need to hear more from black voices. Over the next few days, I will be highlighting influential leaders and giving them a chance to take over my Instagram so that they can speak directly to all of us. I think that's great. 178 million followers.
Holy cow.
I'm Kevin with your Hollywood headlines.
All right, 6:53. It's 104.3 MyFM. It is Valentine in the morning. Jill should be back on Monday. That's what she told us. I think she's taking a couple steroids or something. That's usually the course with MS, unfortunately. And she's an absolute stud in the respect that this girl is coming into work so many days where you don't know it on the other side of the speakers, but she's in massive amounts of pain, she's suffering, and yet she puts on the biggest smile and does such a great show with us every single day. So we'll be happy to have her back in the studio on Monday. But Kevin does such an admirable job as well when he fills
it for her. Thank you, but you're right. Don't compare to her in that regard, though, because I left work because I had a stomach ache one time, and you're right, Jill comes in feeling all that pain and never says a word.
He's got a point there.
My life.
learn from a day. I don't be tripping on this shawty, I let her do whatever she please. I don't be kissing on this shawty, she don't be kissing on me. She came with you to live with me, I was at the point that started you. Don't like the car, she ain't gonna end up buying her new things. That girl know what she wants, she made me take it off, she sees. She say I make a whatever my face pop up on TV. I had to say no disrespect, gotta do it safer, you can keep it. Five star, I'm fresh up out the trap and I'm going deeper. She know I'ma call the way she drop a pin and I come meet her. Stand next to me, you're gonna catch a fever.
Los Angeles. 104.3 MyFM.
MyFam, it is Valentine in the morning. We're following that Amazon warehouse fire going on right now. Brian, where is that? Is that the city of Redlands? The fire, yeah?
Correct.
It's a big warehouse for Amazon, so that's a lot of stuff that was probably coming our way, folks. It may not be coming our way anytime soon, but